Welcome to the third video on the Unit 12 playlist of our Chemistry Matters series. In this video, we'll provide a quick recap of the content covered in Unit 3, Atomic Structure. In Unit 3, the cross-cutting concept of using system models was critical to our understanding of atomic structure. Since we have no way of easily viewing actual atoms, we must use conceptual, mathematical, and physical models of atoms to understand how they behave. We even used a cardboard box as an atomic model. Students drew and built models of the atom, from the relatively simple model created by the Greek philosopher Democritus to the Bohr model of the early 20th century. And as we noted, we keep using these models until we find that they no longer help us explain the new facts we discover about atomic behavior. These models are a lot like maps, and as long as the map takes us to the right place, we keep using it. When the map no longer gets us to a complete understanding of the atomic world, it's time to develop a new map, or in this case, model. In Unit 3, we also explored the primary components of the atom, the protons and neutrons in the nucleus, as well as the tiny, negatively charged electrons moving around the nucleus in areas called energy levels. We learned how Dmitri Mendeleev developed a system model called the periodic table as a way to show patterns of structure and chemical behavior among the known elements. Organized by atomic number and other characteristics, the periodic table reveals trends in physical and chemical properties such as mass, reactivity, and density. And the electron energy levels in the Bohr model revealed to us that electrons pair according to very strict rules. We learned that the Bohr model is not sufficient to explain all atomic behavior. So a newer model is also in use today, known as the quantum mechanical model of the atom. Our students demonstrated the quantum leap of electrons by heating elements during a flame test lab. You saw the colors produced in unique spectra, the same colors that entertain us in fireworks displays. Using the quantum model of the atom and the periodic table, our students were able to determine the position of electrons in an atom, known as the electron configuration. And in the seventh video on the Unit 3 playlist, we produced an electron hotel analogy to make it easier to understand where electrons can go in the energy levels around the nucleus of an atom. Finally, we ended the unit by asking our students to execute a performance task, identifying periodic and quasi-periodic trends among elements based on their atomic structure. We examined atomic radius, effective nuclear charge, electronegativity, and ionization energy. And with all of that completed, we spoke with pyrotechnics expert Mark Angeli, who oversees fireworks shows for the Atlanta Braves, to find out why understanding chemistry is important to giving their fireworks colors. And please join us next for our Unit 4 recap, Chemical Bonds.